Katie Cassidy is a hugely talented Hollywood star on the rise, and she's true showbiz royalty.
I think I love you, isn't that what life is made of?
Her father, the late music idol and Partridge Family fave David Cassidy. Her mother, model Sherry Williams. Her grandfather, the great Jack Cassidy. Her step-grandmother, Oscar winner Shirley Jones. And her uncles, Sean, Patrick and Ryan Cassidy.
So let's go back to the beginning. Cheerleader, you were a model. Is this right? You starred in that Eminem music video, Just Lose It, the kind of one around...
Oh, my gosh, that is hilarious. Yes.
You're in the car and you're looking at Marshall Mathers as he goes jogging by nude. Is that right?
Yes, yes, exactly. And that is so funny that you brought that up. That was like one of my first jobs. I believe it was his stunt double that was running down the street naked.
Don't build a castle for me.
Katie has been in showbiz since her school days, but she was always determined to make it on her own.
It's a really competitive, hard industry. I didn't meet my biological father until later in life. I think I was in second grade. And he and I had a wonderful friendship, but he, you know, was more sort of trying to get me not to lean into necessarily acting. I remember him saying to me, like, okay, if this is what you want to do, you need to do it and do it on your own.
I thought you'd be someone else.
People almost put you under a microscope. But when you are the offspring or, oh, okay, David Cassidy's daughter, let's see. This is interesting. Let's see how good she actually is.
Soon, the TV and movie roles started pouring in. On the big screen, Katie was a scream queen in When a Stranger Calls, and she starred opposite Liam Neeson in Taken.
Where are you from?
California.
I remember he said to me his trick of how he played dead. He took three really deep breaths, and on the fourth breath, he would hold it in, and he taught me how to keep my eyes open for a certain amount of time, and then when they would call action, same with breathing, instead of staring, rest your eyes so that my eye, it actually looked like I was not alive.
We have to save our sister from that crazy bitch.
After juicy roles on TV's Gossip Girl and the Melrose Place revival, where Katie reveled in playing bitchy characters, she found millions of fans as Laurel Lance, aka Black Canary, in TV's Arrowverse.
That's cute.
What kind of fun was it like working on Arrow?
Oh my gosh, it was a blast. I loved every second of it.
Tell me about Oliver Queen. You two had such amazing chemistry on screen.
Oh, thank you. Stephen Amell, he's wonderful. I mean, you become like family when you work every single day for 8 years. You become like a pack and a family, and he was wonderful. And, you know, I think everyone, all of the cast was fantastic, and it just worked really well. And we had a blast doing it, quite frankly. I don't know why we're not still shooting.
Well, and this is the thing, you know, you think of so many of those superhero shows, and the comic books, of course, originally, have gone on to become these epics on the big screen. Why is Arrow not a big screen movie at this point in time? I mean, are there plans, Katie? Do you know?
I don't know. I hope so, just because why not? I mean...
Why not, exactly?
Fans love it. We love it.
Actor and singer David Cassidy has died at the age of 67.
The death of pop idol and Partridge Family heartthrob David Cassidy in 2017 shocked the world, and his daughter, who'd been estranged from her father.
I said, if you ever see me like this, I want you to promise me you'll find a way to let me go.
David had been very candid about his struggles with alcoholism and an array of devastating demons.
It makes me so sad for him, but yeah, he struggled quite a bit, especially in later years. At some point, it's you got to take care of yourself. And for me, I just realized it was healthier for me to sort of take a step back. I still always was really close with my family, my Uncle Sean, my brother Beau, my Uncle Ryan, Patrick. Like, I loved their... really tight. And when my dad passed, it definitely had been like 2 years where I hadn't actually connected with them. And unfortunately, when my father passed, it brought us all together, which was a beautiful thing. But he definitely had some hard times. But may he rest in peace. My dad was an amazing, wonderful man and had such a big heart. And I hope he's okay wherever he is.
I remember April, when the sun was in the sky and love was burning in your eyes.
He left us in 2017. He doesn't just evaporate into nowhere. Do you feel him around you sometimes? Do you think sometimes he's an angel on your shoulder?
Oh, yeah, I definitely am. Sorry, I don't mean to get a little emotional, but yeah, no, I definitely think that's the beauty of it, is that he lives on through me, right? And I do believe love and his heart and all of it is eternal. And I do feel like, you know, in terms of acting and writing and directing and expressing and creating, telling story and in his honor is something that I want to do and need to do, and in that to me keeps him alive here.
I was talking with Ryan a few weeks ago, who's just such a beautiful person, and I feel that same gorgeousness with you as well, Katie, and I mean that. And we were talking about the possibility of a David Cassidy biopic done well. Would you be on board for something like that?
It's funny you say that, because I definitely think that that would be an interesting thing to explore, especially that generation of music and that world. I would love to direct that movie.
So why don't you?
Exactly, right? I mean, who better than his daughter to tell his story?
And in a way, how blessed do you feel that despite the chaos of your lives, you were there together in the end, you know, with his brothers around his hospital bed, and you saw that serenity finally, didn't you, Katie?
Yeah, it was a really, really tough moment. I actually was at a convention in the States when I learned from Steven. I did complete my day at the convention. It was really tough. Then I did obviously leave and go to Florida to be there for his last few breaths and moments. And you know, I do think he went peacefully, and it was tough. It definitely was tough. They all sort of had taken space from him at this time because he did have demons, and he brought us all together again. We were all there with him as he passed. But I do believe forever he will live on through myself and through my brother. I'm blessed and honored and love the fact that I'm able to say that I'm third generation in Hollywood. And hopefully at some point one day I'll have a child of my own and they will continue to carry on the baton. It's like the passing of the baton.
Katie, an amazing legacy, and you are such a big, fabulous part of it.
Thank you so much. That's so kind of you. I appreciate that. I think I-